Good afternoon, Independence. This is Liam Weaver, and welcome to the announcements for Friday, September the 30th. If you actually watched the announcements, you may have noticed that there were none last week. This was due to homecoming. Hopefully, we can get a quick update on the crazy action that ensued.
A big noise playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street, gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
place. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Everybody,
we will rock you.
Everybody's hand in hand, swinging down the lane. Everybody's feeling grand, swinging down the lane. That's the time I miss the bliss that we might have known. Nights like this, when I'm all alone, when the moon is on the rise, baby, I'm so blue. Watching lovers making eyes like we used to.
High School 2011 Homecoming Queen, Miss Rose Chanfarani.
Oh, should be swinging down.
We're proud of each and every.
Congratulations to the senior class for our victory in the Spirit Cup. I am so proud to be part of such a fantastic group of people. The National Arts Society is ready to get started. If you are a sophomore or older, have taken at least one semester of art, and have maintained a B or higher in your art classes, you are eligible. Please come by to our first meeting next Tuesday, October the 4th, in room F140, and see Ms. Helm or Ms. Howard if you have any questions. The University of Kentucky will be hosting their Sea Blue Preview for parents and students on October the 13th at the Factory in Franklin from 7 to 9 p.m. Plan on attending if you are interested in UK. Wednesday, there were 3 accidents in a 24-hour period. For those of you weak in the math area, that is about 1 accident every 8 hours. We obviously need to learn more about driving safety.
Yeah. your mind.
According to a recent study of our school conducted by none other than our own Officer Brewer, less than 70% of student and faculty members wear seatbelts. Remember, contrary to popular belief, stricter driver's license policies and speed limits are not suggestions, they are, in fact, laws. Please be more cautious and courteous when you step behind the wheel. Attention National Technical Honor Society members, please stop by Mr. Steffen's room, B205, and complete a very brief survey by the end of the day today. Do you want to be rewarded for doing the right thing? Keep earning the PBIS tickets and drop them in the boxes to earn prizes. The next drawing is October the 5th at the end of the day, and winners will be announced right here on the announcements next week. Let's take a trip back to an important date in our country's history with our own Alex Basso.
September 11th, 2001 is a date that will remain in our memories forever. But how do you choose to remember it?
Students of Ms. Black's criminal justice class held a memorial stair climb in honor of the victims and the firefighters who helped.
Today we are doing our first 9/11 memorial stair climb, and we wanted to do something to recognize and remember the victims of 9/11, and this is just a great way for them to give back and do something in remembrance of the victims of 9/11.
A group of students would then record the number of flights each runner climbed.
Up and down is one, and we're doing averaging around between 30 to 50 to 60, some of us even 75 apiece.
Students say it's a great way to get a good feel for what the firefighters had to go through on that horrific day.
We're all sweating like crazy, and we're not even halfway there, and they had a lot of heart to go through there and do all that. Trying to catch my breath.
I think the most that we've had so far is about 79. I did 52, and I'm pretty worn out, but it's just a great way to be able to honor those who lost their lives and all the firefighters who had to climb up all those flights of stairs with all the stuff on their backs that they had to carry all the time. So it was just a great way to be able to honor them and just show our appreciation for what they did on that day.
I was notified this morning by my SWAT team commander to bring gear down here today to let the students actually see what it's like for us to train in, the weight of the equipment, and what it feels like to have all that equipment on and actually be in a setting where you're having to do something agility and cardio work and see the effects of the kids.
This memorial stair climb not only taught students a sense of teamwork, but showed them what it truly means to be an American. Back to you, Liam.
Well said, Alex. Today is the day. All lost and found items will be donated to charity today, September the 30th. So if you've lost anything in the past month, please check in Student Services before the end of the day to see if they have it. Unless, of course, you just want to donate it to charity. Mississippi State University has a booth set up now, so go check them out. Well, it looks like Jimmy has kindly taken a brief break from his P90X workout to update us on some geometry.
Hello IHS, this is Jimmy Carlson reporting for IHS Media. And some may wonder, what does Alice in Wonderland have to do with geometry? Let's ask Ms. Hamilton to see what's up.
Hi, I'm Ms. Hamilton, and we are in my geometry classroom doing Alice in Wonderland skits. Lewis Carroll, who wrote Alice in Wonderland, was actually a mathematician, and in the Mad Hatter Tea Party, he used converse statements, which are what we're learning about in Chapter 2. So what the kids are working on today are making their own scripts and acting them out and presenting them in class using their own unique converse statements.
We're just making plays. It has to be 3 minutes, and we have to put converse statements for each person, and I'm Alice, and we include the White Rabbit, the Mad Hatter, and the March Hare and Dormouse. And we all have to make a play, a script, all together, and it all has to equal 3 minutes together.
So the kids have had some pretty unique scripts. We've had a Western theme where the kids just played and wore like cowboy hats and boots and things like that. We had a ghetto tea party. We had a biker tea party. So they a lot of kids took what they could with the Mad Hatter and Alice and the whole original script and really made it their own and made it really fun.
If you are learning converse statements, then you are in geometry. If you are in geometry, then you are learning converse statements. This thing is broken, but that was cool. Back to you, Liam.
Remember, Jimmy, no pain, no gain. It's Banned Books Week in the library. The best defense against censorship is the awareness that we all have the right to read whatever we choose. We must accept and acknowledge that to preserve our right to read whatever we want, that we have to respect each other's choices, even though we might not agree with them. We must realize that if we try to dictate what someone else reads, we're endangering our own right to read whatever we want. Exercise your right to read by dropping by the library and selecting a book of your choice. While in the library, register to win in the Banned Books Week giveaways. The next Risk Club meeting will be on Monday, October the 3rd, in room B208. The next meeting of the Science National Honor Society will be on Monday, October the 3rd, at 2:45 in room D217A. Habitat for Humanity will be meeting Thursday, October the 6th, at 7 in Learning Cottage 3. Everyone likes music, so let's go get an update from the show choir.
Hi, I'm Mary Lee Aitenhan. I'm the vocal music teacher. I teach guitar and general music here. I'm in charge of the show choir, and show choir is basically a group that does singing and dancing at the same time, hopefully successfully and with a lot of fun. We have a concert in October entitled Harvest of Harmony, where we're going to feature all of our vocal groups, including our show choir.
I am in show choir. I'm a bass. That's the lowest part in the choir.
I mean, I can talk like this.
It's pretty fun stuff. I'm a tenor, which means I can sing high. And yeah, I'm just good at that. We went to a trip in Atlanta this past year for show choir. We got 99 points out of 100, and out of the two soloist awards that were given out, I won for the bass soloist, and Rachel here, she won for the soprano soloist. It was pretty neat. We won both for the school, so, you know, it's kind of a big deal.
I'm a junior, and I'm a dance captain in show choir this year. We went to a competition in Atlanta last year, and we got 99 points out of 100, best overall choir and best overall show choir. We're hoping to go back again this year and defend our reign as grand champs.
A couple of songs that we're going to be doing this year are Time Warp, Fix You, that's by Coldplay, Jai Ho, which is a song from Slumdog Millionaire, and a couple of different kind of redneckish songs. It's going to be really funny.
And Miss A is really cool too. She's actually hilarious.
I thought she
was kind of weird being, you know, like a chorus teacher and everything, and I never thought I'd even talk to her. And she's pretty cool sometimes. And then people, you know, go hang out. You get a lot of new friends and stuff. It's just fun.
Well done, show choir. Attention IHS students, faculty, and staff. An ACT prep workshop will be offered by Ms. Mary Lee Bunch at Independence on October the 8th and the 15th as a preparation for the October 22nd ACT here at IHS. Any student, particularly those registered for the ACT here at Independence, is encouraged to consider this ACT prep opportunity. The registration form contains more details and it should be completed and returned to Ms. Bunch with payment by Thursday, October the 6th. Copies of this registration form are also available in the IHS Counseling Center from Ms. McCombs. Interested students should come see their counselor for more information. Students 18 years old and under can attend the UT versus Buffalo game this Saturday for $10. Your code is BUFFTIX. That is BUFFTIX. We still need a Bogs t-shirt design. Dustin Wilmarth has some further information.
Attention seniors, we have a lot of talent within the senior class and we need more t-shirt designs. The deadline has been pushed back, so please bring your designs to Ms. McCombs by October 7th. Come on, seniors, let's get on.
If you would not like to wear a dress, bring your ideas to Mrs. McCombs or Ms. Oyer in the Counseling Center, or send it to Teresa M. at wcs.edu on JPEG. Calling all seniors, Senior Night for Volleyball Lady Eagles is on Tuesday, October the 4th. The girls want all seniors and IHS students to come celebrate their senior night with them. Seniors, there is also a list of your names on the guidance window on yellow paper. Please make sure your names are written correctly on the list. Come see Mrs. McCombs if you have any questions or concerns. And now, sports.
Hey, it's Dalton with your Indy Sports. The Independent Swim Club will have its first practice on Monday, October 3rd at 3:05. Student fees are due at the first practice, along with parent-signed forms and sports physicals. Please see Coach Kim for more information. Now let's throw it over to McCoy for an update on our girls' wrestling.
Hey IHS, this is McCoy Newberg speaking. Most of you know about me winning my state title in wrestling last year. But what you may not know is we also had two wrestling girls state champs, Kendall Barnett and Rachel Savage. And as of now, they're the only two girls on the wrestling team. That is a disgrace. So if you're a girl and enjoy wrestling others to the ground, you need to come out to the information meeting Tuesday, October 4th at 2:45 in Mr. Grindstaff's room, D208. Be there.
Come on, girls. We need more wrestlers. Today I'm wearing Kelsey Yates' bowling shirt to congratulate the IHS bowling team as both the boys and girls squads brought home their first win Tuesday night in the season opener against Centennial. Special mention to this year's team captains, Brighton Shoemake and Courtney Marker. Every year, the IHS team gets further and further in regionals and state competitions. This is our year to go all the way. This week, six bowlers had the 200-plus game. Great job, guys. Let's take a quick break and see what the soccer team is up to this year.
Give me freedom, give me fire, give me reason, take me higher. See the champions, take the field now. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets, our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation, all around us. Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game, and together at the end of the day, we all sing. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
Awesome. The cross country team has an upcoming meet on Saturday at Oakville, Alabama at 10 a.m. Good luck, guys. Football tonight at Hillsboro High School. The game starts at 7 p.m. Come out and support your team. Back to you, Liam.
Thanks, dude. Seniors that did not pick up their POGS gifts from Friday, please see Mrs. McCombs, Counseling Center, for the foam fingers, and Mrs. Montrose at the front office for your lanyards. Seniors, please bring your POGS passes with you. The PSAT will be given on October 12th. Juniors, sophomores, and freshmen who want to take the PSAT can sign up in the Counseling Center. The cost is $15 and checks should be made payable to IHS. The PSAT is a pre-SAT test, and for juniors is a qualifying exam for the National Merit Scholarship Competition. Sign up quickly, as there are a limited number of tests available. The Film Club will meet on Tuesday, October the 4th in room B119, Mr. Chesser's room, at 2:50. Contact Alex Basso or Mr. Chesser for more information. Have you ever used toilet paper to make your clothing? Well, some people do. Sam?
Hey everybody, this is Sam Emery, reporting for IHS Media. Today in Ms. Peters' Latin 1 class, they were making togas out of toilet paper, so I decided I had to check it out.
Today in Latin, we made different kinds of togas. There's a couple of different ones, and so we drew from a bin and picked one and then made them out of toilet paper and old t-shirts.
We made togas.
I made her look beautiful.
I'm Marcus.
Into a toga. She's a boy, and she's looking good.
This project was the clothing project for the culture part of Latin 1, and 15% of the 9 weeks grade is culture, and the students were learning how to, the Romans wore clothes, and they were learning how to make the clothes.
There's not much more to it than getting wrapped in a toga. I took Latin because I heard that it really helps on ACT scores.
I can't look, watch. I can't walk.
My favorite part was just seeing like how people came up with different kinds of ways to make it work and stuff.
Kendall's difficult to work with sometimes too.
I'm a diva.
I think they had fun making it and they learned something along the way. That was my goal.
Well, that was interesting. Sam Emery, signing off. Back to you, Liam.
Latin 2 students will offer tutoring for Latin every Tuesday and Thursday during 5th period in the back stairwell in the Upper D hallway. See Mrs. Peters if you have any questions. Hispanic Heritage Month trivia question. Please see Mrs. Hernandez in D106 if you have the answer. First correct answer earns 4 PBIS tickets for being respectful for the Hispanic culture, being responsible through applying your knowledge, being prompt, being first, and being your best. Este pájaro, nativo a las Américas, fue llamado un guajolote por los aztecas. Benjamin Franklin quisiera que fuera utilizado como el símbolo de los Estados Unidos. ¿Qué es este pájaro? Thanks for listening and have a fantastic weekend.